lifting you higher. You are listening to an exclusive interview. ASOT, the State of Trance.
So welcome, a new item from the State of Trance studio. Going in depth a little bit with the guests that we have in the studio with your questions submitted through social media by the listeners of the State of Trance. This is 10 questions with today's guest, Shapov.
Hello.
First question is from J.I. Visa. Since when are you making music?
It's pretty long way from 2007.
2007, that's a long time.
Yeah.
At what age did you start?
It was, I guess, 17 or 16.
Okay. The next one is from Shata Dru Sun Sharma. How did you start collaborating with Armin? How did you start making music together with him?
I know, just sent the idea what I had and he loved. So that's how we start work, and then we share each other via internet the projects, you know. And then after that we see, first time I see him in Miami.
Yeah.
But before we already did a collab, so
yeah.
Which is fun.
So you had a first version of The Last Dancer, right?
Yeah, yeah.
And you were like, okay, what am I going to do with this?
Yeah.
And let's see if Armin wants to work on this.
Yeah, yeah.
So that's how it started.
Yeah.
Now 1 year later, 3 in the bag.
Yeah, it's EP.
Awesome. The next question comes from Jonathan Sentinel. Do you have any habits which some would consider abnormal for producing songs? So weird things you do in the studio.
I mean, it's like tips.
Oh. Yeah, or maybe you go into the studio and you do something else that other people don't do.
No, you know, my normal day, I wake up and go into the studio. I'm really a hardworking man, you know. I think that if you work in every day, you get something. If you don't work, you didn't get anything.
Do you have any superstition things when you go into the studio? Like maybe you knock on the door 3 times or something like that, something weird? That you maybe
no.
Something for good luck?
Not really, just trying to save positive energy in my soul, mm-hmm. in my heart. This is most motivated things, I think.
And another question also from Jonathan. Which headphones do you use while you're producing?
I like a lot Sennheiser HD25.
Yeah.
Example, if I finish mix, I can listen... In the headphones, it will be different. So if you feel like there's something going wrong,
yeah.
in the headphones, you can try beat mixing in the headphones and then come back to speakers.
Yeah, so most of the times you work on speakers, and for little details, you put on the headphones.
Yeah, and like this one on the loop.
Okay, and then, okay. If you're traveling, you're also producing? With the headphones or?
Yeah, when I travel and I use headphones, but if I have time and somebody can provide me studio, I can go to the studio and work with my stuff. I always bring in, always me.
Always working?
Not always, but so depends what the plan. If I come into the gigs, of course, no time, you know, I focus on the set. Thinking about the set, what I will do, you know, and which tracks I should play, you know, and how it should be.
The next question comes from Dan Eric, and this is a very important question. How do you manage to keep your hair so smooth?
Head and shoulders.
That's the secret, ladies and gentlemen. Head and shoulders. You heard it first. Dan Eric, I hope that answers your question. The next one is one I want to know as well, and this one's by Wicked Violet Music. What is your favorite VST instrument?
You know, I have a lot, but I like use Uha Diva is really nice, and I like Nexus, you know.
Mm-hmm.
Somebody say Nexus, it's simple, but expansion banks there is really nice. You can use a lot of new sounds there. Also like Serum a bit, but mm-hmm. in this time everybody use Serum, but I try and to make some effects on the sounds that it make sounds like original sound,
yeah.
you know what I mean? So it doesn't matter which synth you use, most important what the idea put on the synth and what it will be, you know.
And the 80s kind of sound that you guys made in the new one, that's with the Diva. The pads
in which track?
In La Résistance d'Amour.
It's like combination between Nexus and Diva.
Okay. Well, a tip for you as well, Wicked Violet. Make sure to check out his future music tutorial on YouTube. It's amazing.
Also, you know, it's like you can some secrets. If you do like pets, you can, example, you have the horde.
Yeah.
You can like split the horde, take one high notes from one synth, but the bass notes from the horde you can use from another synth, and it will be interesting combination.
So you take your chords and you just divide them over different instruments.
Yeah.
Hey, that's a good one. I like that. The next one is from Anand Kamat. When are you going to release Chasing Shadows?
Yeah, that's a question for a long time. As I promised, it will come in, I think, in next 2 months.
Okay, that's a promise right there. And next one is also important. Flying on the bumper, one of the most discussed questions on the planet. Do you like pineapple on pizza?
You know, I don't like, you know, I can say if I eat chocolate, I don't like in chocolate something. I like chocolate.
Really? So you don't like a Mars bar or Snickers?
No. I like chocolate, you know. In the same question with pizza.
Okay.
Pineapple, no, but maybe salami, yes, but not pineapple, you know. I don't like some maybe exotic, you know, things, but I like in the exotic things in, you know, like maybe Thai food is good, but not like in simple pizza or chocolate. I don't like when it's something there.
Just plain, simple.
Yeah, it's question I think about that.
Okay. This went into deep. Nice one. Okay, the next one is from I Love Alesso. Do you have any plans for an album?
You know, albums, the thing, I already can't combine all my tracks and make album, but the thing is, if you do album, you need to do, you know, like something different what I did maybe, or do what I did before but make a new way, you know. What's happening now, we have album and it's with Armin. So and like, and before I released my solo EP, so I think for the album it's need time. And it's like it's proper synth in the studio, you know.
Write songs.
Yeah.
Diversify your tracks.
Yeah. It's not right timing for the album, I think.
So let's focus first on Trilogy with Armin.
And for new music, so.
Last but not least, Tiago Lopez asked, what was your dream when you were a child and what is it now?
Sorry?
What was your dream when you were a child? What did you want to become? Maybe an astronaut or something like that? And what is it now?
You know, when I was a kid, I always listened to music. I was always listening to music, like when I was 4 years old, you know. I mean, like, I was listening to Scooter, Prodigy and everything this, you know. I'm like, not listen normal, what usually listening my
You like listening to the details and how they made it.
But it was like different test, you know. I was listening a lot of breakbeat, you know, acid, everything.
Yeah.
And my dream then, I was, I play football a lot.
Yeah.
I was thinking I will be a football player.
Yeah.
But time, same is it. I'm gonna do music, so.
And right now, do you have any dreams for the future?
Yeah, of course I have dream. Every DJ artist want to be, you know, like on next level, have own show, you know. And of course I work hard for it, like every year, and it's my dream, you know. So I keep follow that and also make unique sounds and stuff.
Okay, well, keep an eye on you, Shapo. Thank you so much. Spasiba.
Spasibo.
And that was it for the very first 10 questions with Shapo.
Thank you.
Lifting you higher. This is a state of trance.